Welcome back to Modern Wahine Hawaii. I'm here with one of my favorite segments, actually, when Department of Health drops into the show. I'm here with Malia Daraban, who's with Hawai'i Families as Allies. Hi, Malia.
Hi, thanks for having me.
Thanks for coming on the show. I always love when Department of Health comes on the show because it's such an educational experience and we're sharing so much important information, especially during these times. So thank you for taking the time to be here with us today. We're going to talk about Hawai'i Families as Allies, which is very close to your heart, right?
Right. So Hawai'i Families as Allies is a true grassroots organization that started back in 1986 with three parents on the island of Molokai in a garage. These parents were really concerned about the type of service and supports that their children were not receiving, and they kind of came together and really tried to find a way to help each other. And so through the years, 34 years later, we're still providing support to families as a nonprofit organization. We're fully family led. And what that means is that we're all parents, family members, or caregivers of children that have received services in the child serving systems. And that could be child welfare, Department of Education, juvenile justice, all the different systems. And so I myself am a parent of three children, two that have carry a diagnosis. And I've also been a resource caregiver of five children that have been in the foster care system. So we all have lived experience. And also our board members are 51% or more also parents, caregivers, or family members.
And so, you know, it's great because when you have, as they say, skin in the game, right? Because you're actually participating in the process, you know what people are going through. Can you explain to people why it's so important that, you know, parents stay involved? Because sometimes they think, oh, I'm going to take them to caregiver, they're going to handle the situation. But how important it is for parents to really stay involved in that process.
Right. And so when we think about experts in the field, we as parents are the experts of our own children. A lot of times there's experts that are just experts in their own field and they're very temporary, where we know as parents, it's a lifetime adventure. And what I just try to think is that when I used to share with my son's own service support, you know, we all know what a BLT is, right? A bacon, lettuce, tomato sandwich. And everybody makes their sandwich different. And my son liked his bacon on the bottom. And so sometimes, you know, just thinking about services and supports, it may look a lot different if parents aren't at the table sharing their own experiences. And so through the type of support that we offer is we help families to elevate their voice at the table. We help with self-advocacy, education. We provide a lot of emotional support because we do know that having a child with a challenge or a diagnosis, it can be very stressful. I mean, I spent a lot of nights, you know, waiting till they went to sleep so I could have that ugly cry in the shower, you know? And so being with somebody else that has that same experience and can help you elevate your voice at the table really makes a difference.
I mean, you know, I've talked about this before with the Department of Health individuals, and I try to spread the message as much as possible, especially growing up here in Hawaii. You know, mental health awareness in general has not really been on our radar as much as it should have been. And especially when it comes to young adults and children, you know, I think sometimes parents don't know how to express it or if they should express it, or then they feel like, oh, it's my fault that these kids are like this, or that I don't know what to do about it and I can't handle it. So we're trying to break down the stigma attached with that. Yes. And so thank you for coming on the show and explaining to people that a child's mental health is just as important as everything else, as vaccines, as going, you know, to go and see them for their physicals, checking in them with them mentally and getting them support, especially right now in these craziest of times, is more imperative than ever. Can you share with people about what they should be looking for as far as child mental health awareness?
So I think the awareness of children's mental health is really important. When I think back when I was a parent and my son was just newly diagnosed, I was scared. I felt really alone and isolated and frankly, kind of hopeless. And so Department of Health, Child and Adolescent Mental Health Division has really helped with blazing the way with connecting state agencies and community agencies to kind of really bring awareness and help with stigma. I know a lot of parents around mental health, there is a lot of stigma and guilt like you had shared. And I, as a parent, really felt that too. And I think with families finding the right type of supports and avenues that can really alleviate those feelings of stigma and blame.
Yeah, because for me personally, my son is a teenager now, my daughter is six, and they're getting into those sort of transitional phases where, especially being at home and isolated sometimes when they're having to do schooling online and then transitioning back into sometimes being in school. And there's just so much more to have to process in their young minds that for me as a parent, I didn't know where to go to help, you know, them to alleviate sort of all the scary things that are out there. I mean, it's scary for adults. I can't imagine how scary it would be for kids. So it's so important what you guys do to support families, because the kids get their support too, but the families need to be shored up in order to be able to be there to support the kids as well. So thank you so much for all of the work that you guys do. I can't believe it started all, you know, in a garage in Molokai and how far it's all come. That's so amazing. You know, that's the resilience of people in Hawaii. They figure it out and they just get together and they're like, if I don't know it, somebody's going to know it. And we'll just sort of meet in the middle and just sort of build it as we go. So thanks so much for being on the show today and for sharing such wonderful stories with us. It's so important for people in Hawaii to know that they're not alone, especially in these times, and that they can find help. Is there someplace that they can go to look you guys up?
Yes, Hawaii Families as Allies, hawaii.org is our website.
Awesome. Well, thanks so much, Malia, for being on the show.
Thank you for having me. This is amazing.
Well, you guys are always my favorite. I'm so lucky to have you guys on the show. Big kisses to your family. Stay safe and stay healthy during these times.
Oh, same to you. Thank you so much.